It's January in New York. That's why we're indoors. It's pretty cold out. And Happy New Year to you. A lot of people at the start of the year make New Year's resolutions. That's why the gyms are packed in the first week in January. But by the end of January, they empty out. Which is why I say to you, instead of New Year's resolutions, why don't you set some goals? And in the next couple of minutes, I'm going to tell you how to set a well-formed goal that's brain-friendly and how to achieve it. So to start off with, you want a brain-friendly goal to start with. And what do I mean by a brain-friendly goal? Well, first of all, it's specific so that your brain can wrap around exactly what it's after. And it's measurable. If a goal is specific, you can measure whether you're accomplishing it or have accomplished it. Let me give you an example. A good goal might be, I'm going to lose 30 pounds healthfully by June 30th. That's a specific, measurable goal. I'm going to increase sales by $10 million in 2018. Again, clear, specific, measurable, and it's attainable. If it's attainable, then your brain believes it. If you have a goal that's unrealistic, your brain is not going to work towards it. The last part of that is that you want to put a time frame around it. By June 30th, in 2018. If you have a time frame around it, then you can really go after it, and your brain is aiming at what do I have to do to accomplish it by this time. The one thing I would add to that is that with business goals, you really need to stick to those deadlines. With your personal goals, it's all right to be a little bit more flexible. If you lost 20 pounds in 6 months, that would be pretty good. And you can continue to go after that last 10 pounds. So be a little bit more flexible with your personal goals. The last part of a well-formed goal is that it has to be stated as a positive. For example, if you state it as a negative, like, I will not smoke in 2018, well, the way our brains are constructed is that we tend to delete a negative command. So we would hear that directive or that goal, I will not smoke in 2018, like this, we cut out the I will not, and we would hear it as I will smoke in 2018, or smoke in 2018. That's not what we want to do. Instead, you might say, I will be smoke-free in 2018. So you want it to be specific, measurable, attainable. You want to put a timetable around it, and you want to state it as a positive. The next thing you want to do is you want to write your goals down. Because if you write your goals down, you both get the kinesthetic connection with actually writing it down. You're taking in that information back through your eyes into your brain again. And you're making it real, and you're making it tangible, and you can always pull it out and look at your goal. Now, how do we achieve that goal? Well, you've taken the first step. The second step is you have to have a plan. Obviously, if you're going to increase revenues by $10 million, you want to plan around that. Similarly, if you have a personal goal, like you're going to lose 30 pounds, you need to have a plan around that. What kind of eating plan are you going to go on? Do you have to join something? Do you have to learn some information? Do you have to set aside time to go to meetings? So you need to have a plan if you're going to accomplish your goals. And your plan needs to have milestones. So it can have monthly milestones, weekly milestones. The reason you want to have milestones is because you want to experience success. So having a plan is the first part of achieving a goal. The second part is to celebrate, register, validate your successes along the way. So if you're going to lose 30 pounds in 6 months, that's 5 pounds a month. When you reach that 5 pound total, you want to recognize that and celebrate that success. Similar with any other goal. So that's why you have that milestone, to celebrate and enjoy the successes along the way, because our brains are naturally wired to love success. When we experience success, our brain actually puts out additional dopamine, which is a feel-good chemical in our brain. And we love that, and when we associate it with success, we want more success, and it motivates us to keep going. So have a plan with milestones, and recognize and enjoy and even celebrate the successes that you have. The last part of achieving that goal is all about failure, because we know that we're not going to be in a straight line to achieve that goal. We're going to have ups and downs along the way. And lots of times when people have downs, especially early on in trying to achieve a goal, they just throw in the towel. That's not the time to throw in the towel. If you have a goal that you really want, then you will inevitably have successes and some failures along the way. When the failure takes place, that's when you need the grit of persistence and patience and being kind to yourself. Don't beat yourself up. You realize that this is a natural part of reaching a goal. So that's where you have grit, patience, and success. So if you want to have a great 2018, set some real well-formed goals that are specific, measurable, attainable, and put a timetable around them. Make sure they're stated as a positive. Write those goals down and have a plan for achieving that goal with milestones. Celebrate the successes you have when you reach those milestones, because that will train your brain to enjoy the dopamine and enjoy the success, to want more. And then when you have failures along the way, understand that's part of the process, and have the grit and persistence and patience and kindness to yourself to keep going and achieve that goal. And that's how you'll have a great 2018.